Are you ready to be motivated? Cue the intro. Welcome to your Monday motivation, and I can't start this segment off today without saying congratulations to the New England Patriots and Tom Brady.
But Tom Brady is the greatest player that's ever played in the NFL. You're never, never, never going to see this again. Enjoy it.
The New England Patriots are going to their 10th championship game, which they are the only, I repeat, the only NFL team that has been to double-digit championships. You can look up that stat. It's accurate. The only team with 10, so congratulations New England Patriots. All right, enough of that quarterback talk and NFL talk. Let's talk today about vision. I want to talk today about vision and having a why and having a purpose, especially as you move forward in 2018. If you didn't catch the accent, that was my below average impression of Arnold Schwarzenegger. Most of us watching this right now know who Arnold Schwarzenegger is. He was a Mr. Olympia in the 1970s and 1980s. He's just a billion dollar box office actor who Hollywood never thought that he would make it, and he also became the governor of California. So I really want to talk about Arnold Schwarzenegger today and vision and what that played in his life. I did a little bit of study on Arnold Schwarzenegger, and I found that his confidence, and this is a quote from him, his confidence came from his vision. Arnold is a big believer that if you have a very clear vision of where you want to go, then all the work needed to make that vision come to pass is so much easier. Because in Arnold's case, he always knew why he was training 5 hours a day. He always knew why he was pushing and going through the pain barrier. He clearly understood why he had to eat more and why he had to be disciplined. You see, everything becomes much clearer when you have a strong why, a strong vision. It's not like, oh my gosh, I have to do another 200 sit-ups today. It's more like, I can't wait to do another 200 sit-ups because that gets me one step closer to the abs I need to be the Mr. Olympia. And that's what Arnold's goal was, to be Mr. Olympia. He had a clear vision, a clear why. Arnold would clearly see himself on stage winning the Mr. Olympia. He would see himself very clearly getting the trophy, standing there with the trophy, raising it above his head and having hundreds of bodybuilders around him, kind of below him on stage, basically looking up him, idolizing him, as well as the thousands of people that were watching the event live. That was Arnold's clear vision, and that vision always inspired him to go all out in what he was doing. Arnold was never there to compete. He was simply there to win. And we can take that vision one step further. Arnold had a vision to become a famous Hollywood actor, even though all the naysayers said that it couldn't be done. He was too big, his accent was off, he wasn't an actor, he didn't have any skill. And lo and behold, Arnold had that clear vision of what he wanted. He visualized it, he saw it, he had faith, he had a clear why, he put it into practice, and we all know what Arnold Schwarzenegger became. And nobody thought it could be done. But Arnold believed, he had a vision, he had faith, he had a clear why, and it happened. Another step further, Arnold had a goal to become the governor of California. Again, nobody thought that that would be done. He wasn't a politician, he didn't have a career in politics, and guess what? Arnold became the governor of California. So my question for you, what are your dreams and what are your goals? And is there a difference between the two? Well, I'm so glad you asked me that question, because there's a significant difference between dreams and goals. In my opinion, a dream is just something you fantasize about that probably will never happen. A goal, on the other hand, is something you set a plan for, you have a clear vision, a clear why, and then you work to make it happen. Dreams, goals. Dreams you're thinking about in the clouds, and it's nice to have dreams, but goals are something that you set steps to achieve. So what goals do you have? What goals are you aspiring to in 2018? For me, my personal goal is simply connection. I want to connect with my wife, I want to connect with my kids, and I want to connect with all the people that I know in my life. And thus far in 2018, I'm taking the steps to make that goal come to pass. Meeting with people every week for coffee, taking my wife on a date every week, hanging out with my kids whenever I can, whenever we could set something up, and making that goal become a reality. Clear vision, clear plan, clear why, and you can make it happen. I forgot to do this last week. I have my handy dandy book of 300 writing prompts. So I want to ask you all a question of the week or of the day or whatever, and I'd love to hear your answer. So please comment below. Let me know your answer to this question and I'll answer it myself. So what did you get into trouble for the most when you were a kid? So for me, I was the oldest of two. I have a younger brother and I got in trouble for just picking on my brother. Now I tell my kids, and this is true, and I think hopefully mom, if you're watching, you can vouch for this. We didn't really fight, we weren't mean, we didn't call each other names because we were always kind of told and taught not to do that to one another. So we never did that. I never like called my brother fat and he didn't call me, you know, bad names or anything like that. But I always just kind of picked on him a little bit. And it wasn't in a mean way, it was just like, I kind of pick on Christina now. Like I like to annoy people. I still do that now, but just in different ways. Like I send weird text messages or YouTube links or some way just to tell you that I'm kind of thinking about you, but I'm trying to be semi-annoying, but I'm thinking about you. So for me, it was picking on my brother. What was it for you? What did you do as a kid that got you into the most trouble? We'll see you next week on your Monday Motivation.